In today's video, I am going to explain anatomy of gluteus medius. Gluteus medius is this muscle. This is broad muscle on lateral part of pelvis. You are looking pelvis and hip joint from profile. This is profile view. I am going to explain its origin, insertion, and function. Origin is here, this part. This part is called gluteal surface. Gluteal surface, and where I focus is this part. This is below iliac crest. You don't see origin is iliac crest, but I see this part is very, very important. Why? Because many muscles attach to iliac crest. Gluteus medius is very close to iliac crest. So if this part gets tight, that affects for hip movement and pelvic movement hugely. Very important place. Anyhow, origin of gluteus medius is gluteal surface. This is origin. Simple, right? Insertion is right here, this bony part. This is greater trochanter. Greater trochanter is very big bony bump on lateral part of femur, okay? This muscle originates from lateral part of pelvis, then it goes to lateral part of femur. This thing is very important to understand its function. So, let me talk about its function. Well, general function of gluteus medius is hip abduction. Hip abduction is you open up leg like this way. You open leg sideways. This is hip abduction. Does it make sense? Because this muscle is on lateral part. So this is anterior part. This is gluteus medius. It is on lateral part of hip and pelvis. When this muscle contracts this way, this brings femur to this way. This is hip abduction. This is general function of gluteus medius. What do I mean general function? Because gluteus medius is very broad muscle, you can divide this muscle to two parts. It's like this. You can divide to two parts. This part is anterior fiber. Anterior fiber or anterior part, either way. This part is posterior fiber. Posterior fiber or posterior part. If you divide this muscle to two parts, you can see specific functions. So let me explain specific functions. Alright, you can divide gluteus medius to two parts. What about specific function of anterior fiber? When this muscle contracts this way, this vector of force brings hip to this way. What is that? This is hip flexion, right? This is hip flexion. Then it can do rotational movement, that is internal rotation. Flexion and internal rotation. These are hip movements. What about when this muscle contracts this way? What kind of movement would it do? That is pelvic movement. That is anterior tilt. Anterior tilt is you kind of tuck in pelvis this way, anteriorly, for forward way. This is anterior tilt. Anterior fiber does hip flexion this way, internal rotation this way, and anterior tilt of pelvis, that is this kind of movement. Of course, anterior fiber does hip abduction. As I said, that is general function of gluteus medius. Specific movement is flexion, internal rotation, and anterior tilt. How about posterior fiber? What kind of movement can it do? It is completely opposite from anterior fiber. It does this movement. This is extension. Extension. What about rotational movement? That is external rotation. How about for pelvis, when posterior fiber contracts? This way, this vector of force brings pelvis to this way. This is posterior tilt. Posterior tilt is when you tuck in pelvis this way, posteriorly, back way. This is posterior tilt. Oh my gosh, gluteus medius can do so many things. General function is hip abduction. What about anterior fiber? That does flexion, internal rotation, and anterior tilt. Posterior fiber does extension, external rotation, and posterior tilt. This is like same method of deltoid, deltoid on shoulder joint. This is deltoid. Deltoid is huge muscle on shoulder joint. Origin of deltoid is very narrow, so it's like gluteus medius. Insertion is very narrow, so it's like gluteus medius. You can divide deltoid to three parts. This is medial part. I'm going to focus on anterior part and posterior part. Anterior fiber of deltoid does flexion and internal rotation. Posterior fiber of deltoid does extension and external rotation. Oh my gosh, it is identical like gluteus medius, right? Anterior fiber and posterior fiber. I see gluteus medius and deltoid are kind of identical, twin muscles. But gluteus medius is on pelvis and hip, deltoid is on shoulder. However, this is kind of an interesting relationship between gluteus medius and deltoid. Anyhow, these are function of gluteus medius for movements. Gluteus medius is also important for stability. Stability of hip and pelvis. Well, this is anterior view. Again, this is gluteus medius. This muscle is kind of close to hip joint. It is kind of slightly deep muscle compared to gluteus maximus. Gluteus maximus is most superficial gluteal muscle, where gluteus medius is kind of intermediate layer. It's slightly deep layer. As muscle goes deeper and deeper and deeper, it is more important for stability. Yes, this muscle is important for hip stability and pelvic stability. Now, I want to introduce one more muscle, that is this one. This is iliacus. Iliacus is also deep muscle. It originates from inside part of pelvis. Indeed, very deep muscle. Thus, this is also important for pelvic stability and hip stability. Relationship of these two muscles are that gluteus medius is on outside. Iliacus is inside part of pelvis. You can observe gluteus medius iliacus balance as outside-inside balance. If outside is tight, inside can get tight. If gluteus medius doesn't work, maybe iliacus doesn't work. And do you remember, these two muscles are important for stability. If one of these muscles get tight, maybe hip stability, pelvic stability is aggravated. You can say same thing for gluteus minimus and iliacus, but you know, today's topic is gluteus medius. That is why I focused on gluteus medius for today's video. Anyhow, it is so important for hip stability. In today's video, I explained basic anatomy and function of gluteus medius. I explained its origin, insertion, function, and relationship with iliacus that is important for hip pelvic stability. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.